there's always voiceover later.
Yeah, that's extra work.
Why does the iPad... Does it work?
Hmm?
Does it work? The other way... That did... Oh, no. Never mind. You're not testing. And I can use paste? And like flux?
It did. Seems a little like that. Basically, what the hole does is it lowers the temperature of the melting point.
Takes a couple hours
to take it off. So, but at first you have to heat it till the point that the original solder melts. So, usually it's about 250 degrees. So, what I like to do is put just a little bit of hole on the tip. So, a little more paste, I mean flux, use the regular iron. I want to cold the pads, whatever is there, to the this alloy. Okay. And then after that, take a new filter. This is big. This is like the bigger ones.
I will not be able to do that. I don't think so.
So you basically place around the pads. And then use this.
Set it about 250, so a little faster.
Once the alloy melts, the thing will stick onto the pad a little more. Just basically adjust it. Is my head in the camera?
No.
Okay. Once you adjust it right? So I'm just gonna press on the button. Try not to move it.
Now you're into the camera.
And now that is on, right? Take off the heat.
Let it cool a couple seconds and it'll be cool.
And that's it?
And then that's it. And then you check.
You don't need like any extra solder?
No, that's it. That's all you need.
Oh.
So you require very little.
Okay.
So you have to check if it works or not. Sometimes it's more than one thing that's broken, but primarily it's the filter only. So when you're checking, you don't want to plug everything back. Because that will take a lot of time if it didn't work. The battery and this goes back in. This is the power button. Otherwise, I don't know if to turn on or not. Put the screen back.
So for iPad 3 and iPad 4, they have two separate lines.
Mm-hmm.
So it's left and right. So I want to make sure both sides light up. both side lights on.
That's it.
Why does the iPhone 5 kit have such ridiculous alloys?
Oh.
It's weird.